Welcome to this third video about the best methods to convert primary alcohols into aldehydes. In this presentation, I'll show you the mechanism and several examples of oxidations with DMSO as oxidant, including the Swern oxidation. The intermediate from which the aldehyde is formed in these oxidations is the alkoxydimethylsulfonium cation, shown here in a frame. These can be generated from DMSO and an alcohol by first activating DMSO with an electrophile. I'll show you a selection of suitable electrophiles in a minute. Alternatively, alkoxydimethylsulfonium salts can also be formed from chloroformates or chlorosulfinates, which are obtained from alcohols and phosgene or thionyl chloride. It is also possible to alkylate DMSO with alkyl halides or sulfonates, but this often requires heating to over 100 degrees Celsius. In the presence of weak bases, alkoxydimethylsulfonium salts will fragment into dimethyl sulfide and the aldehyde, as shown here. This elimination can also be induced thermally. Thus, heating an alkyl halide or sulfonate with a DMSO can yield aldehydes directly, in the so-called Kornblum oxidation. In the presence of acids, though, alkoxydimethylsulfonium salts are sometimes converted into alkyl halides or methyl thiomethyl ethers. These are common byproducts of alcohol oxidations with DMSO. A number of different electrophiles have been tested as activators of DMSO. Best results are usually obtained with phosgene or oxalyl chloride, but other acyl halides or anhydrides can give excellent results too. In addition to carbon electrophiles, also sulfur, phosphorus, and other electrophiles can give acceptable results. Even oxidants, such as electrophilic chlorinating reagents or IBX, can activate DMSO. Less versatile are Brønsted acids, which by now have only been used to prepare benzaldehydes from benzylic alcohols and DMSO. The main advantages of alcohol oxidations with DMSO are that no transition metals are required and that the reagents are inexpensive. Yields are often high and other functional groups are usually not oxidized. Overoxidation to carboxylic acids isn't a common side reaction either. The main disadvantages are the anhydrous reaction conditions and low temperatures sometimes required. The stench can also be a problem, but most critical are traces of DMSO and other sulfur-containing byproducts in the final aldehyde. These are powerful catalyst poisons and can cause difficulties if transition metal catalysis is required at a later stage. One popular strategy for laboratory aldehyde preparations is the Swern oxidation, where DMSO is activated with oxalyl chloride. The optimized procedure shown here may also give good results with the less expensive phosgene, di- or triphosgene as activating reagents. As shown later, cooling to only minus 20 degrees Celsius can be sufficient. When DMSO is activated with oxalyl chloride, the initially formed intermediate decarbonylates and then decarboxylates, and chlorodimethylsulfonium chloride is formed. This same reactive intermediate will probably also be formed upon activation with phosgene. This means that, despite its two acyl groups, one equivalent of oxalyl chloride is required to activate one equivalent of DMSO. This is a procedure optimized for large scale, where cooling to minus 20 degrees Celsius did not cause the formation of unwanted byproducts. No racemization of the aldehyde occurred. Like tempo-catalyzed oxidations, the Swern oxidation of primary alcohols is often faster than that of secondary alcohols. In this example, a diol was selectively monooxidized to an aldehyde, without any oxidation of the secondary hydroxy group, despite the excess of oxidant. Here, a 1,3-diol could again be selectively monooxidized to an aldehyde. Despite the anhydrous conditions, no better elimination of the secondary hydroxy group occurred. Here only a slight excess of oxidant was used, probably to prevent this elimination. This is an example of Kornblum oxidation. Because tosylates are formed much faster from primary than from secondary alcohols, the starting diol could be cleanly transformed into a monotosylate. Short heating with an excess of DMSO gave the expected aldehyde. Primary or secondary amines can in principle also react with activated DMSO. Nevertheless, successful DMSO-mediated alcohol oxidations in the presence of unprotected amines have been reported. In this example, DMSO was activated with a slight excess of sulfur trioxide and the oxidation was conducted at 0 degrees Celsius. In this case, however, a Swern oxidation of an unprotected amino alcohol did not proceed smoothly and only a low yield of the amino aldehyde was obtained. It is not clear, though, what the reason for the low yield was. This amine was sterically shielded and electronically deactivated, and I would not expect it to react readily with electrophiles. Thioethers are not usually oxidized by activated DMSO. In the example shown here, beta elimination and formation of acrolein may have been one reason for the low yield. Carboxyl groups may be converted into anhydrides, esters or methyl thiomethyl esters upon treatment with activated DMSO. In this example, though, none of this occurred and a quantitative yield of aldehyde was obtained. But I'll show you a less successful example in a minute. Also, nitro groups can be dehydrated under anhydrous conditions. I could not find any example of DMSO-mediated oxidation of an alcohol containing a primary nitroalkane, but the conditions seem to be compatible with secondary nitroalkanes. In this example, standard Swern oxidation yielded the expected aldehyde, while the nitro group remained unchanged. Unfortunately, the anhydrous reaction conditions combined with the high oxidative and electrophilic reactivity of dimethylsulfonium salts can give rise to many side reactions. When DMSO is activated with oxalyl chloride or phosgene, chlorodimethylsulfonium salts are formed as intermediates. These may function as electrophilic chlorinating reagents and cause the chlorination of electron-rich alkenes, arenes or heteroarenes. Under acidic conditions, these salts can also eliminate chloride and yield an electrophilic formaldehyde derivative which can alkylate various nucleophiles. Chlorodimethylsulfonium salts can also abstract hydride from electron-rich CH groups, as sketched here. Olefins or alkyl chlorides are potential byproducts resulting from this pathway. Depending on the type of reagent used to activate DMSO and on the precise reaction conditions, the yields of aldehyde and of methyl thiomethyl ethers can vary a lot. Some results of the oxidation of decanol with these less conventional activating reagents are shown here. The methyl thiomethyl ether was always formed, but with benzoyl chloride activation under the standard Swern oxidation conditions, its yield remained below 1%. With oxalyl chloride, the same result was obtained as with benzoyl chloride. Reactive electron-rich arenes or heteroarenes can be chlorinated during Swern oxidations. Here, an acyline derivative was chlorinated twice, even though only a slight excess of oxidant was used. Enolizable ketones and other CH acidic compounds can also be chlorinated by chlorodimethylsulfonium chloride. In this example, a ketone was alpha-chlorinated during Swern oxidation of a secondary alcohol. Occasionally, ketones or aldehydes are converted into alpha-methyl thioethers, as shown here. These are probably formed from intermediate alpha-dimethylsulfonium salts by nucleophilic demethylation. In this instance, the oxidation gave a cleaner ketone with hypochloride as oxidant and aminoxyl radical catalysis, which is discussed in part 2 of this video playlist. Methyl thioethers can also result from electron-deficient alkenes or alkynes. Their formation may be slowed down by lowering the excess of oxidant and by keeping the concentration of reactants as low as possible. Alcohols that readily form stabilized carbocations, such as allylic or benzylic alcohols, are occasionally converted into alkyl chlorides during Swern oxidations, in particular if an insufficient amount of base is added. In this example, no amine was added at all, and a complete conversion of the alcohol to an allyl chloride occurred. But even when amines are added, as under the standard Swern conditions, alkyl chlorides may result, as shown here. Carboxylic acids can be activated during Swern oxidations and may be converted into esters or amides. In this example, a benzoic acid was alkylated by the intermediate chlorodimethylsulfonium chloride and a methyl thiomethyl ester resulted. Aldehydes with good leaving groups in beta position readily undergo amine or acid catalyzed beta elimination. In this example, the authors observed variable amounts of an alpha-beta unsaturated aldehyde as byproduct, counterintuitively when too little base was used. On this and the next slide, there are further potential side reactions of DMSO-mediated alcohol oxidations. These include electrophilic methyl thiomethylations, electrophilic thiolations, and the dehydrogenation of various nitrogen-containing functional groups. Highly reactive functional groups, such as isonitriles or epoxides, also readily react with the intermediates of Swern and related oxidations. Then, dehydration of alcohols, oximes, or amides may also occur. Here are some more references, which you can also find in the description of this video. In the next presentation of this playlist, I'll show you examples of alcohol oxidations with derivatives of 2-iodobenzoic acid. These are often easier to perform than oxidations with DMSO and may be better suited for certain applications. See you then!